Wonderful. In my previous video, I taught you how to create a local backend server that connects to the Telegram API and drives the behavior of your robot. In this video, what I would like to teach you is how to move this backend to somewhere that is living on the cloud so that the backend can be active permanently and therefore doesn't require that your machine, your physical computer, is connected to the internet 24/7 running this service. Okay? The way we're going to do that is, first of all, as a reminder, I have my project here on a local folder on my machine. It's on my desktop right now, and it's called blah, blah, blah. It's a Node.js server. And you can see that the main files are going to be the package.json file, which is what defines the dependencies and what this program needs in order to run correctly. And the other one is the bot.js, which is the actual JavaScript code that runs the Node.js server that is running this backend service. So everything else, package lock, and the node modules are the actual dependencies that I will need for the so the actual files that run the dependencies. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this to the cloud, and I'm going to be using glitch.com, which, if you have seen my previous videos, is an online service that is really good for running Node.js projects living on the cloud. And it's also a collaborative coding environment, so you can type code together as if it was Google Docs, and it's also free. So it's one of my favorite projects these days. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new Glitch project, and you can see my previous videos on how to create those projects, etc. And then we're going to create a new project, and we're going to override, just delete everything that is in that project and override it with the files that we just created. So I'm going to go here, create a new project. I'm going to go for the Hello Express template, which is the one that runs a Node.js server on the backend. So it's creating the project, and the project is going, I'm going to call this Telegram bot, for example, pcam telegram bot. Okay, and as I name that, I mean, this doesn't really matter in this case. As I name that, oh, why do I have I don't like, I like the dark. Well, I don't know where that went, but I like the dark being better. Anyway, so you can see that as I start the project, I have a bunch of things. For example, I have backend package JSON, I have a README file, I have the server.js, which is all this template data. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove everything. So I'm going to remove all the files, and I'm going to upload my own files, the ones that I just created. So package, I'm going to remove package.json. Actually, I'm not going to remove it. I'm going to rename it because I will need to take a look at a few things. Especially, I'm going to be needing to use the scripts property for the reasons that I will explain. So I'm going to package.old. So this is not, I'm not going to delete it, but I'm not going to use it either. And then these two folders, public and views, which I'm also going to delete because I don't need them for my project. Once I have this, then I can upload to my project the two files that I actually need, which is the my package.json file and my bot.js file. Those are the two important files. Node modules and the package lock, I don't need those because those will be downloaded and installed by the packet manager that is running on this server. So I don't need to do npm install myself at all. And if I go to tools now and I go to logs, you can see that this is not really working. So let me clear this. You can see that this is automatically trying to install all the dependencies. So it's installing Node, it's installing npm as a packet manager, etc. It's giving me some warnings about deprecations and things that are not supported. And let's see if this actually works. So I'm going to put this here on the side, and I'm going to put my bot here on the other side. And you can see that everything got installed, etc. But I get an error message here. It says that check blah blah blah, command not found, etc. And if I type here blah blah blah, you can see, well, sorry, echo blah blah blah, you can see that the bot is not responding, the server is not responding, and I'm getting all these error messages here. The error is that it's saying that my code is missing a start script. What does that mean? What it means is that because I have installed a server using my package.json file, I am trying to use an automatic service to start my server. But the problem is that I know that I only have my bot.js file, which is the one that has the main code. But the computer in the cloud that is trying to run my server doesn't really know which one is the file that has the main code. Because I could have just one JS file, or I could have 1,000. So how would the computer know which one is the one to use to start? The typical way we handle that is with start scripts, which is a way of defining in your package file, which is the one file that should be executed to start my server. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy two things. First, I'm going to specify that the engine that I want to use is going to be Node version 12. So I'm going to add a comma here to dependencies, and I'm going to say engines. I want to install Node 12. I actually would like to install Node 14. Let's see if that works. Okay, that's one thing. And the other thing is that I'm going to go back here and I'm going to go to scripts, and I'm going to copy and paste this here. And I'm going to say the starting script, the one that I want Glitch to pick up to start my server, is going to be, remember when I was typing on my terminal, node bot.js? So I need to do the same thing here. I need to write node, and instead of server, I want you to execute bot.js, and I'm going to remove this comma here. And as I do that, now my package.json file is done. You can see that it's, because of my changes, now it is installing Node 14.15, which is the same one that I have on my computer here locally. It is installing it, and it's also going to install the dependencies, that not the Node Telegram Bot API. And let's give it a few seconds so that it installs everything. This is all happening automatically because glitch.com, whenever it detects changes on my files, it tries to reconnect and it tries to restart the full server, as opposed to what I was doing manually, which was I was stopping the server and restarting it. So Glitch does that automatically for me. So you can see that this is going down, blah, blah, blah. So I'm installing, etc. And you see, I received an echo request, which means that all this stuff that I wrote before has now been picked up. It was on the backlog, if you will, of so it seems like it's working now. So let's see, echo, are you here now? And then it is, my bot is responding right now. So let me greet Jose Luis. And then my bot is responding, hey, Jose Luis, how are you doing? And so it's working, it's great. So what we were just able to do is to upload our code to an online service, So glitch.com in this case, and have the back end that we wrote locally be running something somewhere on the cloud. So what's nice about this is that I am not running any process on my machine. I could turn off my computer now, and this service, this bot that I just wrote here, will still be working because it's running on a server that is running somewhere on the cloud. So that's great. So now that I have copied the right code, I can delete this file here, the old package file. I don't need it anymore. A few words of warning. Glitch is a great service, but the free version of Glitch is actually quite limited in that it allows you to run processes online, but it puts them to sleep. What that means is that if there is more than, I think, 5 minutes of inactivity, glitch.com will automatically shut down this service and will turn it off to save energy and to save resources, etc., etc. So if you actually want to have this thing really, really living 24/7 and responding to requests, then I think you have to pay some premium, some like $10 a month or something, so that it doesn't put your processes to sleep. Okay, so that's one thing to keep in mind. Or you can use other services, or you can write this on a Raspberry Pi and have it running on your house if you want. You will be paying for the electricity for that anyway. The other thing that it's terrible of this code that I just have here is that, remember what I said before about private tokens? Literally, on my code, I hard coded the password, the token that I need for controlling my Telegram bot. And as I said before, this token is like your password. So anyone that has this token might be able to connect to my Telegram bot and change the behavior, impersonate me, etc., etc. Because this is hard coded here in my code, anyone who sees my code could see this Telegram bot API, which means that because glitch.com is public and it's always open source, I have a problem with privacy here. So how could I still access this information without having it visible in my code? How could I access the information so that it's private to me, the owner of this project, but still I can share this code and I can show it to other people without disclosing my privacy token? Typically, the way that is handled is by using environment variables. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to move on to a new video where I'm going to explain what environment variables are conceptually. And then in the next one, I will explain how to implement those here, particularly with glitch.com. So let's take a look at what environment variables are.